Closeteers, have you ever had one of those days where it's so crappy outside that it's raining and windy and just gross, and all you can do is stay inside and read a book and relax and snuggle and just take it easy? Those days or afternoons or whatever, they're fun. But not when they last for 3 weeks. That weather has been around here for 3 weeks, and I'm sick of it. So I'm rebelling by filming in our gayest room. It's pink. Also, I donned the giant, colorful scarf and the yellow shirt because I need some friggin' brightness in here. Okay? It's Wednesday, it's Zach, and this week on the Closet Collab, we're talking about parents and the parents of your significant other and their inability to deal with your love. First off, I'm assuming that this is taking place with high school age closeteers who have to live with their parents and have to deal with them on a daily basis. Because that's probably where most of the problems come in to play. And as Carly Renee said in her video earlier this week, those parents are probably gonna be pretty picky about whomever you choose to date. There's not a ton of difference between just like straight dating and the gay dating. I really didn't date in high school. This is how I handled being gay in high school. I didn't date. I explored and experimented privately, without my parents really knowing. And it was part of me coming to terms with myself. But a lot of you have already come to terms with yourself and are ready to date. So I don't recommend the not dating if that's not what you do, because it's definitely not healthy. I don't know how my sister dealt with it. She was the one who dated in high school, and my dad was all like, who's this person? Who's that person? I don't really like him, and I don't really like him. I'm sure she did her own dating and just kept it quiet. I guess if it got to the point where you want to tell your parents, or like your parents just know and they don't want you going out, they're not even letting you out of the house or something, you can always talk to a guidance counselor. I go to that a lot, but like in high school, I never used anyone like that, and I probably should have, because they're probably a good help. And if like your guidance counselor's not a good help, find another adult. Maybe one of the sets of parents doesn't like it, but maybe the other set of parents is like totally fine with it. Bring them into it, like talk to them about it, have them help you like arrange meetings, and have them help you open up the conversation with the other parents. Maybe it won't work, but you never know until you try. You know, if all else fails, you're gonna have like a beautiful Victorian style slow romance with your other. You can write letters, you can make YouTube videos, you could talk on the phone, whatever you can get away with, without your parents knowing, that's the way you're gonna interact. Not everyone needs to be attached at the hip all the time and still have a beautiful relationship. There's lots to be said for, you know, letter writing and communication other than face-to-face I know we're all horny and we need to get our, you know, business taken care of, but there's, you know, don't feel pressured, that kind of pressure into having that type of relationship. There's lots of types of relationships, and maybe you're gonna explore one that others haven't explored. So keep an open mind when it comes to relationships and how they work. And if you really want it to work, you're gonna figure out a way, okay? And for those older people, it's a little bit easier. You know, if you're coming out later, like in college or whatever, and your parents are really against it, like, against your gay relationship, I say F them. They don't need to know, and if they're gonna, like, cut off your college funding, there's things like scholarships and grants, and don't think that because they threaten to take things away or take love away or, you know, take privileges away. People live like that all the time. So, you know, you're going to survive and you shouldn't compromise your love for and who you are for your parents' ideas of what they think is right. What you do is you just try to keep communication open. Let them know you're there to talk to, and that you're going to continue doing what you're doing. And, you know, eventually they'll come around. They are your parents. They love you. And if they don't, then you get to create new families and new friends and bonds that will support you and love you the way you should be loved. I mean, it's sad because I would feel sorry for your parents if they didn't come around to that love. But just feel sorry for them and keep the lines of communication open. Hey, so I just wanted to get to some video responses and comments that I didn't get to in some of my last videos. So I just want to thank ToryGirl35 for your video response to the fridge week of videos. Your fridge looked delicious, or the food in it did, and I happened to watch the response when I was super hungry, and I just like, my stomach was growling so much. So thank you for the response. It was wonderful to see your fridge. A couple weeks ago, SBrew8 left a question. What are your opinions on Taylor Swift? Well, SBrew8, I was really digging her songs when they were all over the radio. They're kind of gone now from most of the radio, but yeah, I think she's okay. She's a fun little songwriter. She's no Dolly Parton, but I think, you know, she does well. I hear she sings live horribly, but you know, some people are just recording artists and not live singing artists. I think she has a great team of publicity and agents and stuff like that, because man, she hasn't been on the scene for very long, and she's getting awards and doing everything. So I kind of feel like she's a tool or like a cog in this giant wheel. Like she has the name Taylor Swift, but there is a team that actually makes up Taylor Swift. So that's kind of crazy. And I wouldn't want that life, but if she does, she should live it to the fullest. So those are my thoughts. Thanks, guys. Keep the comments and video responses coming. And hey, let me know if any experiences you've had with parents that just do not get your same-sex relationship. And how have you dealt with that? Thanks. Bye.